Today we will understand some problems related to the weight and the Mingo's rule that are come in the csir-net exams. The first problem is the structure of carboborane C2B4H8 is formally derived from, and our options are closo, nido, arachno and conjuncto. So in the case of C2B4H8, as we know, the formula is Fe2, it means the number of the skeleton pairs of electron is given by this formula. It means 4 into number of carbon atoms, 4 into 2, and plus 3 into number of boron atoms, that are 4, plus number of hydrogen atom is 8 into 1, minus 2 into N, and here N is C plus B, that is 6, divided by 2. So we get the value is equal to 8. It means here are 8 pairs of skeleton electrons. Now the number of vertices is 6, because there are 2 carbon atoms and 4 boron atoms. So the total number of vertices are 6, and this 8 is related to N plus 2 formula, and N plus 2 belongs to the nido family. So this compound will be in the nido. It means number 2 answer is right. The second question is CO4, CO12 adopts the first closo or nido or arachno or hypho structure. And this question is related to the Mingo's rule, the theory of the Mingo's and the weight rules. Get you understand in our previous video, so see that video and then solve the problems according to this video. Now in the case of CO4, CO12, the total valence electron count will be given by 9 into 4, because in the case of cobalt the valency electrons are 9, 7 from the d orbital and 2 from the s orbital, and here are 4 cobalt atoms, so we will take 9 into 4. While the 12 carbonyl ligands donates the 12 into 2 electrons. So the total electrons will be 60. And for the transition metals, the number of the skeleton pairs is given by Fe2 is equal to total valence electrons minus 12 into N upon 2. And here total valence electrons are 60 minus 12 into N upon 2. So we get total 6 pair of skeleton electrons. Now here vertices are 4, because there are 4 metal ions present, and this 6 is related to N plus 2 formula, because N is 4, so N plus 2 is equal to 6, and this belongs to the nido family. So CO4, CO12 will have nido structure, and the option 2 is the right answer. The third question is, according to Waite's rule, the anion C2B9H12- adopts first closure structure, second nido, third arachno and fourth hypho. Now this is the carborane anion C2B9H12-, and for this the formula is Fe2 4C + 3B + 1 × H, and plus the number of the anion charges minus 2N by 2. So we will put the values 4 into 2, because here 2 carbon atoms are present, plus 9 into 3 for the boron atoms, plus 12 into 1 for the hydrogen atoms, plus 1 for the 1 negative charge, minus 2 into 11, because number of vertices are 11, divided by 2. And we get the answer is equal to 13 pair of electrons. Now the number of vertices are 11, and this 13 belongs to N plus 2, and this N plus 2 is for the nido. So our answer is nido, it means number 2 answer is the right answer. The next question is, the total valency electrons count and the structure type adopted by the complex Fe5CO15Cr. Option A is 74 in and nido, B 60 and closo, option C 84 and arachno, and option D, cysti-2 and nido. Now look at this complex Fe5CO15C. Here is 5 iron atoms, this one carbon, and these 15 carbonyl ligands are present. So the total valency electron will be the iron atom, the valency of iron, valency electrons in iron are 8, and there are 5 iron atoms, so it will give 8 into 5 electrons, plus the carbonyl ligand, each carbonyl ligand gives 2 electrons, so 15 into 2 plus 4 from the carbon, so total valency electrons will be 74. Now for this transition metals, the electron pairs are given by Fy2 is equal to the total valency electrons minus 12 into N upon 2. And the total valency electrons are 74 minus 12 into number of the metal ions, that is 5 upon 2. So we get the total number of skeleton electron pairs are 7. Now the number of vertices are 5. And this 7 belongs to N plus 2 group. And this is for nido structure. So this compound will have 74 valency electrons and nido structure. So the option A is the correct answer. The next question that comes in the csir-net exam is the number of skeleton electrons in C2B3H5, C2B4H6 and B5H9s are. The option A is 10, 12 and 12. Option B is 12, 14, 14 and option C is 10, 12 and 14 and option D is 12, 14, 12. So we have to count only the skeleton electrons, not the pair of skeleton electrons. So we will not divide this by the 2. We will only count these electrons minus 2N and we will not divide it by 2. So firstly we see the case of C2B3H5. Here the boron atom gives 3 electrons, so 3 into 3. Carbon gives 4 electrons, so 4 into 2, and each one from the 5 hydrogen atoms, so 5 into 1 minus 2N, and N is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, so 2 into 5. So the total electrons will be equal to 12. Now in the case of C2B4H6, in this case there are 2 carbon atoms and that will give 4 into 2 electrons, 4 boron atoms that will give 3 into 4 electrons, 6 hydrogen atom that will give 6 into 1 electrons minus 2 into 6, then we get 14 electrons. And in the case of B5H9, there are 5 boron atoms, so 5 into 3, and 9 hydrogen atom, so 9 into 1 minus 2 into N, it means 2 into 5, and we get 14 electrons. The right answer 12, 14, 14. Option B is the right option. Let's we see the next question. Total number of vertices in the metal cluster Ru6C CO17, OS5C CO15, Ru5C CO16, R6, 5, 5 respectively. Then they belongs to, the first option is closo nido nido, option B is closo nido and arachno, option C is arachno closo and nido, and the option D is arachno nido and the closo. So firstly see the first cluster Ru6C CO17. The total valence electrons in this, the valency of the Ru is 8 and here are 6 atom of it, so 8 into 6 plus 4 electrons from carbon and there are 17 carbonyl ligands, so 17 into 2 because each carbonyl ligand donates 2 electrons, so total valency electron will be 86. Now we know that the pair of skeleton electrons is equal to total valency electrons minus 12 into N, where N is the number of the metal ions. So that will be 86 minus 12 into 6, because here 6 Ru ions are present divided by 2, and hence we get 7 pair of framework electrons. Now the number of vertices are 6. So the 7 belongs to N plus 1. It means closo group. In the second cluster, OS5C, CO15, the osmium possesses 8 valency electrons. So 8 into 5 plus 4 electrons from carbon and the 15 carbonyl ligands. So 15 into 2. So the total valency electrons will be 74. Now the number of pair of skeleton electrons will be 74 minus 12 into 5. 5 are the osmium ions, so 74 minus 12 into 5 divided by 2, and we get 7 pair of electrons. Now the number of vertices are 5, and the 7 belongs to N plus 2. So this belongs to the nido group. The third cluster is Ru5C, CO16. So the total valency electron in it, we will get in Ru, the valency electrons are 8. So 8 into 5 plus 4 electrons from carbon, and there are 16 carbonyl ligands. So 16 into 2. Total valency electrons will be 76. Now the number of pair of skeleton electrons will be 76 minus 12 into 5 divided by 2. It means 8 pair of electrons. Now the number of vertices are 5, and 8 belongs to N plus 3. So it will belong to the arachno group. So we get 3 structures, closo, nido and arachno. So the 3 clusters belong to closo, nido and arachno structure. So the option B, that is closo, nido and arachno, that is the right one option. This option is the right one. The next question is, the addition of 2 electrons to the bismuth cluster Bi5 plus 3 result in the change of structure type from, the option is closo to nido, nido to arachno, closo to arachno, or arachno to hypho. Now this type of cluster, we have read this earlier in our previous video. You can see that video, and we have tell you that in such type of cluster there is 4N rule. It means 4N plus 2 belongs to the closo group, 4N plus 4 belongs to nido group, and 4N plus 6 belongs to the arachno group. So firstly we will count the total valency electrons, and in this case there are 5 bismuth ions. So 5 into 5 minus 3, that is from the positive charge, so we will minus it. It means total 22 valency electrons are present here. Now the number of vertices, it means the number of ions that are present, is 5. So this belongs to 4N plus 2 group. 22 electrons belongs to 4N plus 2 group. So it will be closo structure. Now we are adding 2 electrons to it. It means after adding 2 electrons, the total valency electron counts become 22 plus 2. It means 24 electrons. So now this will belong to 4N plus 4 group. And this is nido. It means nido structure. So it becomes closo to nido. It means the option A is the right option. It means closo to nido. The next question is, the cluster having arachno type structure is, the option A is OS5CO16, option B is OS3CO12, option C is IR4CO12, and the option D is RH6CO16. Now we will see each cluster separately, then we will judge which has the arachno type of structure. Firstly we see the first option, that is OS5CO16. In osmium, the valency electrons are 8. So the total valency electron in this cluster will be 8 into 5 plus 16 carbonyl groups are present. So 16 into 2, because each carbonyl group gives 2 electrons. And hence total valency electron will be 72. Now by the Mingo's formula, the number of pair of skeleton electrons will be 72 minus 12 n divided by 2. It means 72 minus 12 into 5, that is the number of the metal ions, divided by 2. It means 6 pair of electrons. Now the vertices are 5. 5 metal ions are present, and then this 6 belongs to n plus 1. It means it has closed structure. So this option is not right. Now we comes to the another option, that is OH3CO12. In this, the total valency electrons are 8 into 3 plus 12 into 2, that is equal to 48. So the pair of electrons, framework electrons, will be 48 minus 12n. It means 48 minus 12 into 3 divided by 2, that is 6. So there are 6 pairs of framework electrons. Now the number of vertices are 3. So this 6 belongs to n plus 3, and hence this cluster has the arachnoid structure. So the option B, that is OH3CO12, is the right option, that has the arachnoid structure. If you will solve these two clusters, you will find that these does not possess the arachnoid structure, only this cluster has the arachnoid structure. So these are some problems that we have solved from the csir-net exams. In the similar way, you can solve many other problems. Hope you will like this video. Meet in our next video. Thank you.